Kanye West might be in grave danger. So Milo Yiannopoulos, Kanye West's former chief of staff, came to Twitter and he said that the reason why Ye cannot successfully release music or clothing is because his dentist has him hooked on a new drug. So he says there is a reason Ye, formerly known as Kanye West, is no longer capable of successfully releasing music or clothing. In fact, there are several reasons, but the most serious and the most recent is his dentist, Thomas Kennelly. He says, Kennelly got Ye hooked on nitrous laughing gas. It is my belief that Kennelly sought to diminish Ye's mental faculties so that Kennelly and his business associates could extract millions of dollars from him. Earlier this year, I uncovered the fraud and intervened. Ye hooked on nitrous blew up our relationship on purpose by proposing something that he knew I'd have to resign over because I had told him so. The resurrection of his longtime idol fantasy of making prawn. Thomas Kennelly is a dangerous predator who targets African-American celebrities into whose mouth he puts fake diamonds, as I suspect he did to Lil Yachty. He must be stopped. I filed a complaint with the California Dental Board last week to that end. And so my thing was, why are we just now hearing this? You was in Kanye West's corner working with him when everything was going good. You was calling him a genius. You was his right-hand man. And now all of a sudden that you do not work with him anymore, now you're like outing this situation. But I instantly knew something was wrong when Kanye West proposed the idea of doing Yeezy Prawn. If you know anything about Kanye's story, you know that he has a serious prawn addiction. He's made it very clear in abundance of interviews and podcasts that it derailed his life. You don't believe me? Just take a look.
When I was young and I would go to the video store, if I wanted to go into the adult section, it was a curtain, it was a person sitting there watching, making sure that kids didn't go in. If the kids went into that section, there was a video camera and they would have you be escorted out of that section. Now that section is forced through TikTok. That section is subverted and kind of mixed with the drink inside of music directed at children, inside of content through Disney, on Hulu, which is Disney also, and in so many branded commercials to confuse children and to sexualize our children.
There you have it right there. That was Kanye West's stance on it not too long ago. He's clearly making a point about how accessible prawn is to children these days. But you gotta remember who Kanye West is. Kanye West is one of the biggest rappers, one of the biggest musical artists ever, and a lot of his fan base are children. So when Kanye comes with the mighty idea of doing Yeezy Prawn, that has to be a little weird to you. Why would he create something like that when he has several interviews where he's speaking against it?
For me, Playboy was my gateway into full-on pornography addiction. My dad had a Playboy left out at age 5, and it's affected almost every choice I made for the rest of my life. Mm.
Listen, somebody who's really stable mentally, their actions and their decisions are going to be pretty stable for the most part. You're not going to be one person one day and then the next day be a completely different person. So for anybody who's a Kanye fan or a Kanye friend or a Kanye business partner, when he says, hey, we're going to do Yeezy Prawn, the first thing you should have said was, what? The stance you've been on this whole time was about how it derailed your life. So now to tie this back together with the nitrous oxide, there has been signs in front of our face this whole time that something was wrong. Whether it's his mental health, whether it's addictions. Kanye has been transparent about some of his addictions. He's been transparent about his prawn addiction. He's been transparent about his addiction with alcohol. And believe it or not, he's actually been transparent about his addiction to nitrous oxide to a certain extent. Check this out.
And Garcia, this is Ye. I'm on the nitrous.
And I was at the dentist's office the other day. I was taking a nitrous oxide. I suggested if anybody's like stressed out.
You suggested if anybody is feeling stressed out. Now, I've never did nitrous oxide before, laughing gas, at least I don't think. But I don't think that's something that you're supposed to take when you're feeling stressed out. So that was already a sign of potential abuse of the substance. But then when you look right here, it says this Insta story was from about a couple years ago where he says, I'm gonna do a free commercial for nitrous oxide. So the first thing that's going off in my head is, where are Kanye's friends? And so my thing is, I'm not saying that Milo wasn't genuinely in Kanye West's corner. But what I'm saying is, if he's been struggling with this for a few years, And this Thomas Connelly guy is the culprit behind it all. Why didn't you, Ben, say this? Why are you saying this on August 7, 2024? So we actually got another tweet from him where he says, it was my job to protect Ye from bad guys, since he is all heart. And to be quite honest, just doesn't and can't see them coming. I was paid well for doing it. I don't deserve any awards, especially since I should have seen the dentist coming and stopped them sooner, as I did with so many others. Having said that, there's no doubt in my mind that had I not intervened, Ye would have been Michael Jackson'd in May of this year. I accept that my friendship with Ye is probably over forever now, but my conscience is clear now. So you didn't see the dentist coming, but this fan that makes this video saw it coming. And so maybe there is not a right way or a perfect way to go about this situation, but the point that I'm trying to make with this video is something clearly has been wrong with Kanye West. I mean, we've always talked about his mental health, bipolar disorder, but then when you tackle on these addictions on top of that, it just makes it so much worse. So I really don't have much solutions, but there is a Bible verse, Proverbs 14:12, that speaks to this. It's biblical. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way to death. In your heart, in your mind, it may feel like the right thing to do. When you're feeling down, when you're feeling depressed, when you're feeling stressed, taking these substances might seem like the right thing to do. But in reality, its end is the way to death. It's not the right way to go. There is wisdom in this verse right here. And same with Milo. At the beginning, working with Kanye seemed like the best thing possible. Saying yes to all his ideas to avoid him ranting at you or firing you might have seemed like the best idea, the best route to go. But the reality is, its end is the way to death. We have to realize that though it may seem right, though it may feel right, it's not always right. What do you think? Comment down below. I'll see y'all in the next video. Prayers up for Kanye. Peace.